It's the Batmobile!
Welcome back to Build the Batmobile. We are going to tackle 6 issues this episode. 34, 35, 36, 37, and of course 38. Last time where we left off, we constructed the rear axle with the springs and the shock absorbers. We are going to continue on this. We're going to use these parts in issue 34. There are actually some springs attached in this episode. And we're then going to install this to the rear, no, sorry, to the frame of the car. So let's start quickly with our issue. We're going to install the front hangers, which are, let me take a quick look, are so going to be on these parts over here, on the short section of the springs itself. We have, as I said, the parts here, and I've already set aside this over here, which is the box with all the spare screws. So let's open up the bag and let's see what we got. So let's first identify the parts before we start working on it, because we have 34A and 34B, which look the same, but luckily we have a picture showing us which one is which. Oh, and by the way, it says secure the left spring hanger, which is A, and I see that there is an L etched on this part over here on the top. So that'll make it a little bit more easier. So let's get the rear axle ready. And what we're supposed to do is we are supposed to screw this one on using large screws this time, which is the first time we're going to use these, I believe, which are going to be the AJMs. And you know what the M stands for, right? Oil. Right, so let's open up our little jar of oil and install these parts. Well, that took a bit more effort than I thought. The screw wouldn't go in, but finally it's done. Part 1 and 2, or stage 1 and 2, have been completed, and we now have to use our little spanner again, which we got last time. Was it a spanner? No, wrench. That was it, the wrench. Because we're now going to install the rear hanger, which is C. Are these marked as well? Let me check. I don't see a marker on it. Are these? They look similar to me. They are actually. They seem to be very similar. Hold on. Yeah, they have one identification letter, 34C. So these are identical. So what we need to do now is turn it around like so, and then how do I want to, oh, okay, so this goes over, no, hold up, oh, it does go over here, this is weird. So what we need to do is get one of these. Oh, I see, so yeah, okay. This goes in this hole, and this goes in this hole. I see. So this is what they want us to do, and then use the wrench to put on the nuts. And before we're going to do that, I'm going to use some oil just in case something goes wrong. Don't expect anything to go wrong. But nonetheless, let me take out this U-shaped part and add some oil to all the holes where it's going to go, so it will go in much more smoother and stay in much more smoother. With these parts in, we're now going to install the rear suspension and axle to the frame of the car. I have put the frame of the car on the table upside down and added a few things on this side. Can you see that? Let's see. Yeah, you can see that. added a few things over there to lift the part up a little bit so the engine block is not resting on the table. We're going to install these parts over here into these parts over here. However, before we do that, we need to take these springs and the instructions suggest we put the springs on these parts. I'm not quite sure that is a good idea. Wouldn't it be a better idea if I put the springs in here? Let's first see if it works the way they want us to work. So I think the best thing we can do first is before we're gonna install any kind of springs. Oh, this is the wrong way up. Oh, sorry, it has to go, of course, like this. Before we're gonna install any of these springs, we might want to fix these so at least we know that they are in the correct orientation. But like this, okay. Okay, I think we ran into a small problem. I'm not quite sure what happened. So I have decided to screw in these things first, as I mentioned, using two EM screws. So two over here, two over there. And I thought, why not just screw in this one first, then this one, and then follow up with the other two. So at least they are in the right order. But, and this is a big but, if I screw this thing in, then this thing is not going to fit because maybe you can see it and maybe not. This hole may be correct, but this hole over here should correspond to this hole over here. So I'm not quite certain what happened. Also, when I look at this over here, this can would fit, but this won't. So we either need to... Oh, wait a minute, we need to maneuver these springs back and forth. Okay, now it will fit. Okay, so I thought this was actually a case of I did something wrong, but apparently we need to just push and pull this part. Okay. Good, I'll take some other two EM screws and screw these in. Well, I got enough EM screws to spare, so I do not need to open up the bag yet. Okay, so now it is in correct position, and now I can actually screw these much more tight. Okay, that's in. So now we're gonna have the important part of having to maneuver this into this. I'm not quite sure if I can do this simultaneously, both of them, but I'll certainly try. So here goes the spring. Oh. And this needs to go. This is not going to work as I am. Let's try put the springs inside the tubes. And this one is in. That's in. Can I do the same over here? Actually, it was actually more easy than I thought it's going to be, he said. Is this correct? Because they're very loose. They want us to use EM screws. Do I have some spares? I believe I do. Yes, I have some spares to screw in the rear section of the suspension. Okay, but this is very loose. I mean, okay, they're not going to fall out, but I'm not liking this at all. Let's try to put it on its side to avoid any mishaps. Okay, I'll have to screw this in very tightly, I believe. You see, it's loose. That's what I thought. It just fell out. Okay, I'm either doing something completely wrong or this is... it's not good. Okay, well, let's try to fix the other one. Maybe when the car has some rear wheels and tires, it will sit more firmly, but for now, I don't like this system. And if everything else fails, I'll simply have to glue the thing together, which I sincerely do not hope I need to, but try to fix this. So I put the spring in first, then try to match these two, which absolutely do not seem to be working. So I'm wondering if I have did something wrong. I've posted the question on Facebook. Let's see if someone responds. So what I did was I glued the springs onto these parts. That was a bit difficult. So what I did I put some glue, super glue on these parts, then put the springs into these red shock absorber parts, and then really pushed in these rods so that the glue would now be on the spring. Hopefully that will mean that the spring is now glued onto this part, making these pins a little bit longer, and then they will stay now inside the shock absorbers. I hope this works. Someone else has done this. I'm not quite sure if they've done this because the pins kept falling out, but at the moment they seem to be in. So let's continue on with stage 35, which is actually the steering mechanism. So we got a lot of cool stuff in here, including some nice looking shaft with a cog on it. Right, let's see what we need to do. Oh, we are most likely going to be using this for that, the oil for that. So what we're gonna do is just put in some oil under the gear and then have the gear placed inside over here. You get this part, which is plastic, by the way, which is kind of annoying. Okay, we put some oil on that part as well. And then see if we can actually get this thing in and that it stays in. This part needs to be like so. And this part needs to be like so. Actually, I think pure accidentally, I have already succeeded in that. Okay, before I'm gonna screw everything shut, let me test if this is in the correct position, because there is a picture over here showing me that this part should be like so, and then this should be like, okay, I understand. Okay, next part is gonna be, we're gonna screw in the universal joint, which of course also becomes, needs some oil. And no, let's start with the universal joint first, using ZM screws. These need to be not too tight, because they will need to be able to move. This joint is supposed to turn, so let's not screw it in too tight. Took some finagling, but I have obviously installed the steering wheel shaft, as they say it, to the universal mount. And now I actually can move all the way around. And now I believe we should actually enter the more difficult part of the stage, which is connecting this to the steering mechanism. Although, well, maybe not. First we need to connect this to the frame of the car. So let's get this part, let's get the frame over here, and let's put this magazine away for now. So this needs to be screwed on over here, and I want to make sure that it's still in the correct position. Hold on, because I need to check this orientation as opposed as I just need to check this orientation. Is this still correct? I believe so. Yes, okay, so let me try to screw this thing on using the AM screws. And before I start turning on this shaft, I need to check. Well, actually, I can actually, they told me I have to check the orientation in stage 2, but I don't see the point of that, because if just we do not have to turn the car upside down, which we are going to do that using the same method we just used, using this box and then two pieces of Tamiya paint, the two jars, to have it turn upside down. And now we need to connect the steering axle over here to this axle over there. And if we just keep turning this part over here, well, first we need to make sure that this wheel, of course, now is, hold up, that this is in the center. So all I need to do is simply turn the shaft until. Okay, I think I found the correct orientation. So this part clicked in the metal shaft as expected. And we need an AM screw to secure it into place. Okay. And let's screw that in. Is it secure? Yes. So now when I turn the steering wheel, we can see the wheels, well, steering as it were. So that will be issue 35 gone, and I have another bag of AM screws to spare, so let's put them in the big box, including the ZM at the moment. So let's put the ZM in here as well. No, hold up, in here, and head on to issue 36, the drive shaft. Are we going to install the drive shaft into the car in this issue? Yes, we are. But first we need to deconstruct the drive shaft itself. So let's take the car, let's hold up, before I do that, are we going to install the drive shaft upside down? No, we are not. So we can put the car or the frame back on its correct orientation and start working on the next stage. Let's start with stage 1, which is once again a universal joint. Joy, I like those. That was being sarcastic, by the way. So we need this part and a universal joint and AP screws. Oh, this is new. Well, these are all plastic, so yes, it's AP all the way. So let me screw these in. And I can be a bit more firm, a bit more tight this time. Okay, that's in. Now we need, what stage? 36F. Which one is this? Because I have several of these. Oh, never mind, I can already see it. It has two of these, let's say, grappling arms, as it were. So it's this part. And a little bit more tighter, otherwise you can see a gap. Okay, tight enough. Next part will be something different. It's going to be this part over here, 36E, which is the drive shaft bearing. So that has to go over here, like so. And then we actually have two of these halves, which are going to fit over. Oh, this is a weird construction idea, but this has to go over like so. So we need to first click these two together. That is to say, click it over here together, yes, and then screw it shut, also using the AP screws. And then on the end of that part, which we just screwed together, we put another universal joint. All right, which is the last actual part of this set. This stage, I mean. Okay. That's that. So put our AP screw back. We're gonna most likely gonna need it in the next stage, because now we're going to install the car or the drive shaft onto the car using the remaining four AP screws and screwing the universal joint to the other section of the car. Let's see which one goes first in. So this long shaft goes up front and the short shaft goes in the back. So we have the universal mount grappler, as it were, over here from the engine block. Let's screw it in. So the shaft is in. It's a weird thing, because I believe that as soon as the floor pan is going in of the car, which is going to be the next stage, we will not be seeing this drive shaft anymore. Okay, I needed the assistance of another lamp, and now, of course, you can't see anything. So let's see if I can turn the lamp like so. This is getting a bit more difficult than I anticipated, because it's all black on black on black, and I can't see anything. Okay, and now we need to turn the axle so actually I can actually reach the other side. Okay, let's turn the entire thing around. Okay, it's in. Well, I must say that concerning issues 34, 35, and 36, when I first glanced at them, I thought this is going to be a breeze. This is going to be dead easy. But I was wrong. I have promised to continue on working with two more issues. Issues 37 and 38, so let's do that. And I believe I can safely say that these are going to be less cumbersome than previous. And the reason for that, let me first turn off the secondary light. The reason for that is they are actually going to be very large parts. Actually, one part and 12 screws, 12 cm screws. Let me get the part, which is this part, which is the underside, the what is it called? The floor pan. Metal, as I said, one part and 12 screws. Let me remove the magazine over here so we have a better view. And we are supposed to screw this thing on right now. So this, I thought it was actually the front, but it's going in like so. Right. Let's make sure that the steering column, of course, is over here. And we have to be sure that this, hold up, I have put this thing over here, this cable. So let's make sure that that is not longer around this frame over here. Are there any more cables which I have turned on frame? No, there aren't. Okay. Oh yeah, I see them. Okay. Yeah, that's it. It's going to go in like that, like so. We already noticed there is a hole over here. This is most likely where the speaker is going to go. I'm not quite sure if we're going to use the speaker, that small speaker, but, and this is where a on-off switch is going to come. Also uncertain if we're going to use that later on. I have a feeling that Model Mods is going to make a power mod for this car as well, but I haven't seen it available yet, so it'll probably become available in the next several weeks or months. But let's start screwing in the CM screws using, of course, our oil, and I will be back with you as soon as all the screws are in. So the floor pan is in. The car is now getting some weight, which is of course just logical. The last part, that's the last stage for this video, is going to be part 38, which is also a floor pan, but most obviously with some openings for chairs, and this is most likely going to be the battery pack. Once again, we hope there is going to be a power mod for this car, because I'm the freak not going to turn this car upside down every time we need to change batteries. Once again, CM screws. This is going to come in like so. And yeah, once again, I will come back to you as soon as this is in. Okay, well, actually I had that part in, and then it turned out that this part over here, remember that that thing we had over here? That was crooked, so I couldn't get it in. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to push it from the bottom up, and hopefully, yep, first screw in the that section onto the floor pan, and then turn the car around and screw the floor pan in. And with that done, I can turn the car back, oops, back the correct way up, keep the plastic floor pan in place, and once again screw in using the CM screws from the this side in. So these 10 screws need to be screwed in again, but at least the bottom part is now in the correct orientation. So with the plastic floor pan now back in with all the 10 screws, we have, oh, I have actually created a blister on this finger now with all the screw driving. But yeah, as I was contemplating just now, looking at these magazines at the first glance, I thought this is going to be a breeze getting everything together. But well, it turned out it wasn't that easy as I thought, especially with the rear axle and the rear suspension. I have posted the question on Facebook for the group build to ask them if I did anything wrong with these suspensions. I haven't received an answer yet, but I did see another video where someone actually also used some glue on the springs. Not quite sure if that was the reason he used the glue, but I tried it and so far it seems to work. So let's just keep it at that. Steering system is in as well. Once again, the steering is not perfect, but it's in, it'll work. The drive shaft is in, and of course the floor pan is in. Next time we are, as far as I know, we're going to work on the brake lines for the rear wheels, including the brake pads. And I already saw one of the rear wheels. We're going to wait for construction until we got the other wheel as well, because I don't want to have it sit on balancing on three wheels. I want to have the four wheels complete for the next stage. We'll hopefully see you then. Thank you so much, and until next time, bye bye.
Nice fucking model.
BNT, custom made models and dioramas. Ha! Like, you click and subscribe, you must.